This conference will now be recorded.
Today we are having with us our friend, very well known theater artist, thinker, and pioneer today in a movement against the monster economy.
Yes.
And he's particularly now amongst the villagers, now amongst the people who are working in the small villages, and he is there, rooted there. So he'll be sharing with us on the eve of the Foundation Day of IPTA today, when in the name of COVID-19, the monster economy is playing havoc, not only in our country, but throughout the globe. So some lessons can be learnt, that how we have treated the nature and how the nature is responding to the mankind. So there are lessons to be learnt. We learn through the experiences of our friend Prasanna ji, and particularly at this juncture, juncture of crisis of COVID-19, how the artist community should come in closer contact with the people who in a way are returning to their native places for want of food, and there is a likelihood of there is an eventually for want of food there may be food riots and whatnot. So the whole situation is very critical. I on behalf of IPTA National Committee, I welcome Prasanna ji, and I will like that he should share his experiences with us. So through this, we'll share the experience, his experiences, to the whole community of artists in IPTA and even outside IPTA. So welcome, Prasanna ji, and now over to you.
नमस्कार साथियों, और आपके फाउंडेशन डे के संदर्भ में मेरा शुभकामनाएं सबके लिए है। राकेश जी ने कहा कि आज के संदर्भ को अंडरस्टैंड करने के लिए एक दो नया शब्द हम लोगों ने ढूंढा है। इस इकोनॉमी को, इस सिस्टम ऑफ प्रोडक्शन एंड सिस्टम ऑफ इकोनॉमी को हमने मॉन्स्टर इकोनॉमी कहा है, और जो नया सिस्टम ऑफ इकोनॉमी, नया सिस्टम ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, अब पीपल सेंटर्ड प्रोडक्शन को हमने पवित्र आर्थिकी या पवित्र अर्थव्यवस्था कहा है। ये दो शब्द बहुत प्रॉब्लमेटिक है। अभी हमारे बहुत सारे साथियों इस शब्द को मानने के लिए तैयार नहीं है, क्योंकि इस शब्द को इतना बर्बाद कर दिया गया है कि वो अभी भी बहुत इस शब्द से दूर रहना चाहता है। मैं कहता हूं, इस शब्द से दूर रहने से कुछ होगा नहीं, इस शब्द को फिर से पवित्र बनाने का काम रह गया है। क्या मतलब है इसको पवित्र बनाने का? मतलब बहुत सरल ढंग में कहा जाए, ये पवित्र शब्द या पावित्र या गॉड या खुदा या भगवान, इसको शुरू से मानव जाति ने शुरू से दो ढंग से निपटा रहे हैं। एक ढंग ये है कि ये जो काम करने वाले लोग, हाथ को यूज करने वाले लोग, एक ढंग से इसको समझते हैं, और हाथ को नहीं काम करने वाले लोग, व्हाट यू कॉल द ब्राह्मिनिकल establishment and the easy establishment has always looked at it in an opposite way. Unfortunately, it is this Brahminical notion or the notion or the priestlyhood notion which has become prominent, and as a result, we are a little wary. But if we are wary, the monster economy and the political establishments which are taking the advantage of the monster economy will be very happy, because it will become very easy for them to isolate you from the people, which is exactly what has happened in India, which is exactly what is happening in Brazil, in, you know, almost all over the world. इसीलिए हमने सोचा क्यों ना कुछ दिन थोड़ा कंफ्यूजन रहे, फिर भी हम इसी शब्द को यूज करेंगे और इसी शब्द का शुद्धिकरण कहा जाए, वो शुद्धिकरण हम करेंगे. यूसी एंड इन दिस प्रोसेस थिएटर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इन दिस प्रोसेस इप्टा इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज लेट मी टेल यू इट इज थिएटर which has understood the dynamic dualism between these two concepts. I am talking of a dynamic dualism. These are dual things. One is a real structure, the other is a transcendental structure. Now, how does a working person or how does a folk artist, for example, handle this dualism? The folk artist knows that what he or she is doing is a lie. Folk artist ko ye malum hai ki main natak kar raha hu, aur natak karte waqt unko ye malum hai ki main kuch cheezon ko istemal karke ye magical action la raha hu, aur ye jo magic jab hota hai wo hota hai ऑडियंस के दिमाग में. द ऑडियंस विल इन फैक्ट गिव देयर फेथ, उनका अपना यू नो फेथ को देके दे क्रिएट दैट मैजिकल एक्शन, एंड आफ्टर द परफॉर्मेंस इज ओवर ऑल दिस पीपल विल हैप्पीली गो एंड गेट ड्रंक इन अ टैवर्न एंड डिस्कस द परफॉर्मेंस. नाउ लुक एट दिस अमेजिंग थिंग, they are discussing the performance means they are critically looking at the performance. There's nothing magical about it, but they have all contributed. The actor has contributed, the theater has contributed, and also the audience have contributed in creating them. So this dynamic dualism between God and nature, God and theater, God and human being is managed very well by the poor people. They can manage it because of one amazing trait of these people. I call it a very amazing trait, which we have been talking about, but not necessarily understanding it very well. What is that trait? The trait is all of them are hand-making people. मतलब हाथ से काम करने वाले लोग हैं, दिमाग से सोचने वाले नहीं हैं. मैं मतलब मैं नहीं कह रहा हूं कि उनमें से दिमाग नहीं है, बट दे आर नॉट द पीपल हु डिपेंड सो मच ऑन द हेड, बट दीज आर द पीपल हु डिपेंड ऑन द हैंड. नॉट ओनली दैट, दे कंस्ट्रक्ट देयर गॉड इन देयर हैंड्स. दिस इज वेरी वाइटल फॉर अस. दे डोंट कंस्ट्रक्ट देयर हैंड देयर गॉड इन द हेड. When you construct your God in the hand, you see, what is that God? It is the work. Kabir ke liye bunkari karna hi bhagwan hai. Ravidas ke liye chamar ka kaam karna hi bhagwan hai. Isiliye to Ravidas ji ne jab Kashi Naresh उनके पास आए और कहे कि आप मेरे दरबार में आ जाइए, आप इतने बड़े संत हो गए हैं, आप यहाँ क्यों रास्ते के बगल में इतने गंदगी में बैठे हैं? रविदास जी ने कहा, जी मैं तो आ सकता हूँ, खुश हूँ क्योंकि आपने बुलाया है, पर मैं आ जाऊं आपके पास तो मेरा भगवान छूट जाएगा। ये जो बात रविदास जी ने कहा कि मेरे भगवान छूट जाएगा, कैसे छूट जाएगा? बिकॉज चमार गिरी छूट जाएगा। सी चमार गिरी इज गॉड फॉर रविदास, चमार गिरी इज गॉड फॉर और बुनकरी इज द गॉड फॉर कबीर एंड फॉर ऑल दीज पीपल इवन टूडे हु परफॉर्म रूरल थिएटर और हु सी रूरल थिएटर, फॉर देम दे बोथ आर डायनेमिकली लिंक्ड टू ईच अदर। इट्स देयर इज अ ड्यूअलिज्म बट इट इज डायनेमिकली लिंक्ड। हम जो शहर के लोग हैं, हम इसको टूट गया है, आई मीन यू नो वी हैव ब्रोकन इट। शहर के लोग ये दोनों को हटा दिया है और दोनों को सेपरेट कर दिया है, और हमें कहा गया है कि ये सेपरेशन हम साइंस के वजह से किया है, साइंटिफिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग के वजह से किया है। मैं नहीं मानता हूं ये साइंटिफिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग है। मैं मानता हूं ये डिवीजन इसीलिए किया गया है, मार्केट के वजह से किया गया है। बिजनेसमैन डज नॉट वांट गॉड टू इंटरफियर इन द बिजनेस बिकॉज द बिजनेस कैन बी डर्टी, द मार्केट कैन बी डर्टी। व्हेन यू आर डूइंग मार्केट यू आर necessarily doing anti-God activity, because अब झूठ कहते हैं, पदार्थ होता ही नहीं है, product is not there first, you create a market for the product, so it is the businessman who creates these divisions and says भैया भगवान को हम ऐसे जगह पे रखे वहां वो शुद्ध रह सके, हम ऐसे जगह रहेंगे और काम करेंगे जहां अशुद्धि भी चलेगा। तो एक तरफ से बिजनेस अशुद्ध है और दूसरे तरफ से भगवान को अपने घर के अपने औरतों के पास डीप इनसाइड द हाउस उसको रख दिया गया है, या तो मंदिर में रखा है, मस्जिद में रखा है, या चर्च में रखा है। इससे दोनों को नुकसान हो रहा है। दिस इज वॉट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड। This is what has become extreme in the monster economy. This division has become extreme. This division is helping, Ambanis, Adanis, and every Tata, Birla, every one of them. It's also helping the political establishments. It is Mr. Narendra Modi, or whether it is earlier Ravan Singh, it is helping them. एक तरफ से वो शुद्ध रहेगा, एक तरफ से ये रहेगा, हम बीच में हम मैनिपुलेट कर सकते हैं। ये बीच में मैनिपुलेट करने वाले कौन है? जरूरी नहीं है वो। इस वजह से हमने कहा है ये पवित्र आर्थिकी नाम का एक शब्द हम ढूंढ ले जिससे ये दोनों डायनामिकली लिंक्ड हो जाए। नाउ दिस इज दी थियोरेटिकल बेसिस, but actually I am not saying, our Gram Seva Sangh is not saying anything very very new. In fact, let me humbly confess here that these are the things which all our great radical theater people, our masters, tried it out over the last 2-3-4 decades. In this sense, I want to talk about, I want to take 4 of them who I know, I know their work, which is, one is Habib Saab, the second one is Badal Sarkar, the third is Fritz Benewitz, this German director, this extraordinary German director who kept coming to India for nearly 3 decades and went on working with village people, with small communities, with students and whatnot. And then also Alkazi Saab. Of course, in all these, the most important person in terms of today's discussion would be Habib Saab. Because it was really Habib Saab who tried to link the sacredness and the working people together for the first time in this country. It is not Gram Seva Sangh, it is not Prasanna, it is Habib Sahab. When Habib Sahab, for example, produced Charan Das Chor, what was he doing? He was linking the working person with God. God as the working person perceives, not as Mr. Ambani perceiving or Adani perceiving, or not even as RSS perceives or the Jamaat Islam or whatever perceives. See, this is very important. And in that perception, it is very interesting that, you know, the whole moral structure is changed. Habib Sahab is providing through Charan Das Chor a new moral structure. What is that moral structure? Charan Das to chor hai. Chori karna to galti hai. Par Charan Das chori isiliye karta hai ki usko jina hai. He's a poor fellow. He has to live. He is doing the chori. And then in the extraordinary play, there is a situation where he is challenged that bhaiya tum chori kar sakte ho, but on these conditions and all that. And then you have all seen the play. I don't have to explain it. You see, at the end of it, we realize that Charan Das is a far more dignified, far more morally upright person than most other characters in the play, whether the king or the queen or anything. You see, we have unfortunately perceived Habib Sahab's politics. We have not perceived Habib Sahab's cultural action. IPTA or Samudaya or any of these organizations are first and foremost cultural organizations. They should feel confident that they will advise the political establishments on culture and not the other way around. You see, in any case, political establishments today can do very little about the current crisis. The current crisis is a crisis of civilization. It's a much larger crisis. Simply politically, you cannot handle it. Take China, for example. China got its strength because of socialism. China got its strength because of the amazing work that the Chinese people, the Chinese party, the Chinese communists did between 1948 and 60. They set up the base for China's growth in terms of rural development, in terms of primary health, in terms of primary education, and in terms of a decentralized system of production. And then the whole thing, because of their some people's aggressive urge to become better than America, better than the paper tiger, that they go haywire. You know, the political establishment changes in China and many things happen. And as a result, today, do you call China a socialist country or an imperialist country? China is interestingly both. It is socialist, but it's also imperialist. It probably owns more land in Africa, more factories in Africa and India than anybody else. So I am saying, I mean, I'm still a socialist. People think because of my dadi, which happened because of a tragedy in my life, that I have become Gandhian and all that. I have great respect for Gandhiji, but I'm still a socialist. As a socialist, as a person who is inspired by people like Habib Sahab, wants to tell that God is, after all, not such a dirty idea. I want to tell that God is a beautiful idea and we don't need to throw the baby with the bath water. I think the left is throwing the baby with the bath water. No, we should not do that. The baby is what we've all been here for. It's the baby for which we are all fighting for. So let's protect the baby and throw the bathwater, which has become dirty. Now, let me also take the other persons just to further the argument which I started with Habib Saab. For example, Badalda. No, Badalda. Badalda, of course, had his politics, which is very different from what you know, most leftists are saying and all that. You know, and you know all that controversy that happened between him and Utpal Dutt and all that. Fact remains that Badal Da was the first one to shift away from the face-related acting, the face-related theater, to a body theater. मतलब हाथ और बदन को पहली बार इस देश में फिर से सामने ले आया बादल दा ने. And the way Badal Da, you know, tried to make a language using the body, using the gesture, using the dynamic is something amazing. Of course, even then, I used to tell Badal Da that, Badal Da, you have a problem. You are Michil. You know, that is procession. I said it is just a procession of words. It is not a play. You have called it very correctly as procession, because it is just a procession of words and maybe ideas, but it has not become a play. That flaw remained with Badal Da, which made him a very unhappy person when he died. But with all that, we cannot negate the extraordinary contribution that Badal Da has given to what you can call the radical theater in India. Badal Da is very important for radical theater in India. Tisra artist main charcha karna chahta hu, wo hai Fritz Benewitz. Now this Fritz Benewitz, a crazy German, I don't know why he kept coming to India. I still cannot understand. But he kept coming to India and kept working with Indian people. Maybe the bug had been put into him by Bertolt Brecht, that there is something different in Indian theater and in Indian dramaturgy. And so he was maybe looking for that. Whatever it is, you know, I want to discuss this production of his, the first production, in fact, that he did in India with the Tamasha actors of Maharashtra. इस प्रोडक्शन को मैंने 70s के शुरुआत में देखा था, 75 और 76 में, जब मैं नेशनल स्कूल ऑफ ड्रामा अभी तभी तभी ज्वाइन किया था, शायद फर्स्ट ईयर में था. उस वक्त वो दिल्ली आए थे एंड इट वाज एन एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी प्रोडक्शन. एंड दिस एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनरी प्रोडक्शन वेयर द प्ले इज अ जर्मन प्ले रिटन बाय ब्रेक्ट ककेशन चाटसर्ग. And there are these actors who are chamars and, you know, mostly untouchables, who did not know anything but spoken Marathi. Fritz Benewitz did not know anything except German. In fact, after many years after that production, I had asked Fritz and asked him, how did you manage to communicate with them? And how did you manage to produce such an extraordinarily dynamic production, which is so full and so beautiful and so Indian looking as this? And he just looked at me for a while, smiled and said, it is common sense. He said, I tried to link myself up with the common sense of those working people. Now, look at this extraordinary word, common sense. Now, there is this word called common sense. Then there is this other word which we use for non-intellectual communication called sensuous communication, sense organs. So suddenly, he was in just one word, he was telling you, idiot, don't go for too much of intellectualism if you're a theater person. A theater person is essentially trying to make the communication sensuous. The actor is providing not just the sense, but the actor is providing authenticity through his or her personality. So all this one could get from Fritz Benevitz. And then Alkazi Saab. Alkazi Saab to bourgeois looking the. Alkazi Saab to kafi bade aadmi the, you know, Bombay se the, and he was, you know, all that. But then, you know, I mean, I had a very difficult relationship with Alkazi Saab. It wasn't easy at all. But then, the way this man transmitted the system, the training system, the rehearsal system, the discipline, and all that was truly amazing. And also, the way, for example, it was, let us face it, it was Mr. Alkazi who brought Brecht into India, to especially into North India. It was Alkazi Saab who brought Benevitz into India. It was Alkazi Saab who produced plays which were not very popular, which were not very this thing in India. And it was Alkazi Saab who produced a glorious line of actors who later became very, very different from the regular bourgeois theater actors. So whatever is our problem with Alkazi Saab, I think Alkazi Saab's contribution also is very important. So I think the time has come for us to understand our own seniors, our own mentors in a different way. We have to revisit them. We have to revisit Habib Saab. We have to revisit Badalda. We have to revisit, Fritz Benevitz and Alkazi. So this is what I want to say. And tomorrow looks very bleak on one side. It looks very beautiful on the other side. We don't know whether we'll survive as a humanity. We don't know. We may perish. If we perish, we perish. I have no problem with that. But if we have to survive, we will survive only by our method and not by Mr. Ambani's method or Adani's method or even the Microsoft owner's method. That's very clear. Ye, विश्व आगे बढ़ेगा तो हमारे कार्यक्रम से आगे बढ़ेगा, उनके कार्यक्रम से तो नहीं. हो सकता है थोड़ा रिपेयर करके मॉन्स्टर इकोनॉमी को फिर आया जाए तो दो साल और चलेगा, तीन साल और चलेगा, बट इट विल कोलैप्स लाइक अ बैड व्हीकल इवन मोर. एंड सो फाइनली माय पॉइंट इज, आई डोंट नो वेदर वी विल बी एबल टू सर्वाइव, इट डजंट मैटर, बट लेट अस पुट ऑल अवर हार्ट एंड माइंड, नॉट माइंड एंड हार्ट बट हार्ट एंड माइंड into the project, because our time has come. IPTA's time has come, Samudaya's time has come, and the time for the village has come. I don't want to speak too much, but let me take just 2 minutes talking about the village and then open it for our discussion. You see, all of us have gotten into the habit of looking at the village as the crisis point. अरे भैया villagers घूम रहे हैं, उसको कैसे हम food packets पहुंचा दिया जाए? अरे भैया ये बुनकर trouble में है, उनको कैसे हम पैसे पहुंचा दिया जाए? Right log, that is the farmer is in distress, so how do we give him some help? By doing this, we have actually made them into beggars. We have actually made them to lose their confidence, which they had, they lived, and they lived better than us. And we have made them also cynical, they suspect. What we need to do is actually go there to learn from them, not just learn from them, but also teach them. I don't want to romanticize the village people. I know how terrible, how difficult it is to work with the village people. I have done it for about 25, 30 years. But unless we mutually learn from each other, unless we give them an equal respect, and unless we realize that we have something to take from them and not just give them, we have something to take from them, especially in terms of their skills, their capacity to use their hands. We have lost our skills. We have become, in fact, the biggest problem of the machine is that it has killed our skills. It has killed the skills of the hand, of the body, of the eye, of the mouth, of all the capacities. So when we look at the village, we have to have a complete new way of looking at the village. The political establishment or the business just doesn't have, I don't even expect them to have. But at least I think we can have this new way of looking at the village and a new way of doing theater. With these few words, let me hand over the mic, so to say, to all of you comrades, and thank you very much.
धन्यवाद प्रसन्ना जी, थैंक यू प्रसन्ना जी। हाँ विनीत जी,
ओके कमरेड, लेट मी फर्स्ट कांग्रेचुलेट यू, इट वाज एन एक्सीलेंट एक्सीलेंट डिपिक्शन ऑफ प्रेजेंट सिचुएशन एंड व्हाट यू टॉक्ड अबाउट थिएटर वाज वेरी एनलाइटनिंग फॉर मी। बट सिंस यू टॉक सो मच अबाउट वर्ड्स, sacred and monster and god, I have one problem with your division, rural versus urban, because you know, in urban areas also, in Bombay Dharavi, there are people, would you classify them as rural, would you classify them as urban, because they have got influenced by urban culture, but still there are men and women working with their hands. And when we are talking of a sacred economy, we have to include these people. A whole lot of them are in towns and metropolitan cities. So that's why I have this problem with rural and urban.
Jayaji, thank you for provoking this clarification. In fact, sacred economy is a word which came up because of this problem. You see, otherwise, there was Sarvodaya, there was Gandhian economy, there were a whole lot of words which were available. And even now, a lot of our friends are saying, aap kyun ye sacred ke peeche pade hai, aap kyun Sarvodaya pe wapas aa sakte hai. We said, sacred economy is the word coined because we have accepted 40% automation and only 60%. This was precisely to include Dharavi. It is precisely to include all the garment workers, women, and it is precisely to include up to SME. You know, a lot of SME is actually comes within this 40% thing. In fact, it is to include the trade union movement of India. You may not have noticed it, but actually, the Indian trade union movement today is almost entirely within this 40% bandwidth. Uske bahar ke log hai, wo aapke paas nahi hai, wo aapke paas nahi bhi aana chahte hai. Wo to shares or securities or this and that and all that. So I am thankful to you for reminding me. Sacred economy definitely includes them. IPTA should definitely include them. Samudaya should definitely include them. Not just include them. They are. They have all the benefit. They have the preparation to go to the village better than we have. Thank you.
कोई और है? मैं एक बात आपसे शेयर कर रहा हूं प्रसन्ना जी।
हाँ जी,
मैं ये बता रहा हूं कि हम लोगों ने, मैंने आपको पहले बताया कि हम लोगों ने उत्तर प्रदेश के करीब 30-40 जिलों में बहुत सघन यात्राएं की गांव-गांव तक। तो एक बार जब हम लोग यात्रा कर रहे थे तो मैंने आपको जैसे पहले बताया कि अपने गांव की तरफ भी लोगों ने कहा कि आप सब जगह तो हमको ले जाते हैं, अपने गांव कभी नहीं ले गए। तो मैं अपने गांव भी ले गया सारे साथियों को। तो वहां पर मेरे बचपन में एक वहां ट्राइब है जिसको कंजर कहा जाता है, जो क्रिमिनल ट्राइब माना जाता है। अगर वो कहीं अपनी जगह से बाहर जाता था तो उसको पुलिस में रिपोर्ट करनी पड़ती। अभी शायद है कि नहीं, अब वो खत्म हो गया, लेकिन तब तक ये था। तो हम लोगों को बचपन में वहां उसके आसपास जाने नहीं दिया जाता। पहली बार अभी 8-10 साल पहले, अपने लगभग 60 साल के उम्र के आसपास पहुंचने पर हम उन लोगों के पास गए और वो एक गीत गाते थे मेरे बचपन से, जो बचपन में हमको सुनते थे, लेकिन हम उसको वहां पे कभी जाने नहीं दिया जाता था, हमको डरा दिया गया था, कभी के पास नहीं गए थे। वो गीत की लाइनें हैं, कोई इलम मस्त इल्म, कोई इलम मस्त कोई चिलम मस्त, कोई राग रागिनी जुए में सगरी मस्ती पेट भरन की, इनको घेरो कुएं में। तो जितना इल्म है और जो चिलम जिसको आप मास्टर इकोनॉमी कहते हैं, वो तब से कह रहे हैं कि ये सब पेट भरने की मस्ती के लिए ये सब कर रहे हैं, इनको कुएं में डाल दो, जरूरत नहीं। तो मैं समझता हूं कि ऐसे ना जाने कितनी गाथाएं बिखरी पड़ी हैं, जिनको मैं अपने साथियों को और आपने एक हमें रास्ता दिया है बताता हूं कि उनसे सीखने के लिए हमें जाना चाहिए, उनको सिखाने के लिए नहीं, उनसे हमें हो सकता है। और मैं आपको बहुत धन्यवाद करता हूं कि हमारे एक कहावत और हमारे एक बुजुर्ग गांव के कहते थे कि कितनी चिड़िया उड़े आकाश, चारा है धरती के पास। तो कितनी भी आकाश में उड़े, तरह तरह की उड़ाने भरे, लेकिन चारा धरती के ही पास है। तो मैं समझता हूँ कि आपका रास्ता वो चारा ढूंढने का रास्ता है, धरती के पास जाने का रास्ता है, जड़ों के पास जाने का रास्ता है। और कोई भी कला बिना जड़ों के पास जाए किसी भी तरह से समृद्ध नहीं हो सकती, ये मेरा दृढ़ मत है। हवा में वो कभी फल फूल नहीं सकती, जड़ों से ही वो फल फूल सकती है। कला भी दरख्त की तरह है कि वो जब तक जड़ें उसकी गहरी नहीं होंगी, वो दरख्त कभी बड़ा नहीं हो सकता। अभी तो हम लोग हवा में लटके हुए कला कर रहे हैं, शायद इसको जड़ों तक पहुंचने की जरूरत है। और अगर कोई साथी आपसे संवाद करना चाहे तो उनका स्वागत है, और नहीं तो हम आपके इस शुभकामना संदेश को अपने और तमाम साथी कलाकारों तक लेकर के जाएंगे। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
Prasanna,
yes,
it is good to listen from you that you are still a socialist, not a Gandhian, in so clear words.
thank you.
Distinction between Gandhi and socialist.
Gandhi was also a great person, and he was also, to some extent, he was socialist.
Non-Gandhian होना क्या compliment है?
No, not at all. But he said that he is a socialist. So it's on a lighter note. Thank you very much. It was really a very wonderful, very wonderful, and very memorable kind of an address which I heard after a long time regarding theater. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Mm-hmm.